Hi everyone. Over the next few days, I'll be posting videos about the five elements that make our bodies up and everything around us. So we're made of the same five elements that make up the entire universe and everything around us. So this will help us to understand a little more about each element and how each element holds substance, character, and manifestation. Okay, and how to connect at a more deeper level with these elements. So the first one I'll be talking about today is the element of earth. Okay, so when we think of earth, the first concept that comes to our mind is the planet earth, or mud or sand. Okay, let's delve a little bit deeper and understand it at a deeper level, at a more profound level. The first attribute that the earth element holds is the power of holding anything and everything together, the power of holding together with the power of gravity. Now, the earth itself has a core which has a gravitational pull that affects every one of us or everything on this planet, right? There is nothing on this planet or no one on this planet that doesn't share a relationship with this gravitational or gravity energy stemming from the core of the earth. Now I heard something in a video on a course that I'm doing online, an Ayurveda course, and one of the teachers said the earth holds a plant as much as a tree. The earth holds a king as much as a beggar. The earth holds a rose as much as weed. So without any judgment, the earth holds and supports and nourishes everything equally. No judgment, but the same support, the same strength. So the second attribute is neutrality and strength, okay? Now, how do we re-establish this relationship? We live in a day and age where we live in buildings, sometimes skyscrapers up to 20 floors, 30 floors. So it is understood and it's quite obvious that that connection between us and the earth is weakened or even lost sometimes. And the weaker this relationship gets, the more unsettled we feel within our being. So unsettled, ungrounded, or that feeling of not knowing where we belong, okay? And the more we express a healthy relationship with this element of earth, the more stable we feel, the more grounded or centered we feel within our own being, and emotionally more stable as well. So what can we do to rebuild this connection to the element of earth? There are three things that I will talk about, three yogic practices that we can practice. The first one is walking bare feet on the ground. If you're lucky enough to have a backyard or a garden, you can do that very, very easily. So consciously, with intention, walking on the ground. So each step, feel the connection between the sole of your foot and the earth, and feel that alignment of your body with that gravitational energy stemming from the core of the earth. That is the first practice. The second practice is shavasana. So the final resting posture that we assume in any yoga asana practice, it is one of the most important, or even I would say the most important asana or posture in any yoga asana practice. So lying down on the floor. And while we're lying down on the floor, we want to bring our awareness to the interface between the body and the earth. Okay, if you can, of course, doing it on the grass or on the ground is one of the best options. But even if you're doing it at home, on the sixth floor, on the 10th floor, know that visualization, intention has really, really, really a lot of power to bring in that connection or to feed into that relationship with that element of earth. So lie down on the floor and just metaphysically allow yourself to sink into the ground. sink and melt your entire body and find this connection between you and the earth. Okay, the third one I will talk about is just standing. So if you're not able to lie down anywhere, even just standing and building that awareness, consciously feeling that alignment of your body with the earth or with that gravity, or with just building awareness into the soles of your feet and feeling that connection with the earth is a way to feed into that relationship and earthing and grounding yourself a little more. Okay, so the more we take time out of our schedule or just take a second or a couple of minutes to build that awareness with this connection that we have to the earth, the more stability we will bring into our being, the more grounded we will feel, the more centered we will feel, and emotionally stable as well. Okay, so I hope that helps. Please do practice these two or three practices that I have just mentioned, and I'm sure it will do wonders. So in the next few days, I will be posting videos about the other four elements. I hope you like this video, and please share it and implement this in your life. Thank you so much. Namaste. Have a great day. Lots of love.